Today's port swigger tutorial is entitled DAMXSS via an alternative prototype pollution vector. To solve the lab, we must call the alert function by polluting the object that prototype with a property that is then used to execute arbitrary JavaScript. If you don't know what prototype pollution is, you should check out the previous video on the subject, DAMXSS via client-side prototype pollution. I talk about prototype pollution more in depth there. I'll make sure to link the video in the description below. The first place we usually look for prototype pollution is the URL. Try polluting the object.prototype with an arbitrary prototype via a query string. Say __proto__.evil equals polluted. Open the developer tools by pressing F12 and go to the console tab. Check if you have indeed managed to pollute the object prototype. Object.prototype. We can see that indeed the object prototype contains our injected property. This means that we have found a prototype pollution source. Next, we need to study every JavaScript file and identify any properties that are used by the application. For this, go to the Debugger tab, Resources.js. We can see free JavaScript files. The first file loads a jQuery library. Before Angular and React were a thing, jQuery was used to manipulate the DOM and handle JavaScript events more easily. The next file is very conveniently commented. It looks like it defines a jQuery plugin named parseParams that parses query parameters from the URL string and returns them as a JavaScript object. Finally, we see the searchlogger alternative file. The searchlogger function is the place where the vulnerability arises. As you can see, eval is being used to dynamically execute code based on the manager's sequence value. We have identified our sync. What we have to do now is see if the property that is passed to the sync is an exploitable gadget. Let's talk a little about this code snippet. Two objects are being initialized on the window object. The first one, macros, is an empty object. The next one, manager, has two properties. The params property, which stores the results of the URL query parameters using the parseParams function we've seen earlier. The second property is a method called macro. This method takes a property parameter and checks if the macros object contains a property with the given name. If it does, it returns the value of that property. Moving along with the code, this part is pretty straightforward. If manager.sequence does not exist, A takes the value of 1. After this, manager.sequence becomes A plus 1. Let's try it in the console. Let's check the properties for the manager object. We can see the two properties defined earlier, params and macro, as well as the eval property inherited from the object prototype. So no sequence property. This means that manager.sequence should be 2. And it is. Next, we have the eval function. It checks if manager and manager.sequence exist, and they both do. If they do, it calls the manager.macro method with the value of manager.sequence as an argument. Seeing that the sequence prototype is not defined, we can pollute the object prototype by adding a parameter called sequence with the value of alert. This means that the macro method is going to be called with an alert function as a parameter. In JavaScript, a function can take another function as a parameter. When the macro function is called, the alert function will be called immediately, which will display the alert dialog to the page. Let's try this in the console. Manager.macro of alert. This calls the alert. Now let's pollute the object prototype with the sequence parameter. Add proto.sequence equals alert to the URL. Back in the console, we can see that the manager now contains a property called sequence. Check the value of the manager.sequence. We get alert 1 because of the code snippet that adds a 1 after the value of manager.sequence. When manager.macro of manager.sequence is called, this does not cause the alert to be triggered. It instead causes an error because we now have some invalid code here. However, we can, for example, write alert minus 1. We cannot use plus because the URL parse function replaces pluses with spaces and it will strip our plus sign. Let's try it out. Manager.macro of alert minus 1. This indeed triggers the alert. Finally, modify the URL again by adding a minus sign after the alert. proto.sequence equals alert minus. This solves the lab. An alternative to manual testing is using Burp's dumb invader. For this, we need to use Burp's built-in browser. Copy the homepage for the lab, go to Burp proxy intercept, and click the open browser button. In the browser, paste the lab link. Click on the browser's installed extensions, select Burp suite, set dumb invader to on, then go to attack types and also set prototype pollution to on. Click the reload button. Dumb invader automatically checks the page for sources that enable you to add arbitrary properties to the object.prototype. To see the results, open the developer tools again. Go to the dumb invader tab and select dumb. Dumb invader has identified two potential techniques for polluting the object.prototype. Press the test button for the first one. Dumb invader opens a new tab in which it adds an arbitrary property to the object.prototype. To test that this worked, open the developer tools. The object.prototype has already been queried. As you can see, it contains the test property. Now create a new object. Let's say let my object equals an empty object and check if it inherited the test property. My object.test property. And it has. We have confirmed that prototype pollution is indeed possible. Now let's scan for gadgets. Click the Scan for Gadgets button. A new tab was opened again. Go to it and open the developer tools. Go to the Dumb Invader tab. As you can see, Dumb Invader has identified the eval sync. Click the link for the stack trace. Then go to the console tab and open the last link printed in the stack trace. This will send us to the JavaScript file where the sync was found. Back in the Dumb Invader tab, we can also click the exploit button to automatically generate a proof of concept exploit. A new tab is opened and an alert function is called, but it does not trigger. If we go back to the previous tab and look at the identified eval sync again, we can see that a one character has been added following the closing canary string. This means that a one character is being added to the payload containing the alert, causing it not to work. Go back to the tab containing the exploit and append the minus character to the URL like we've done in the manual solution. Now, when we reload the page, the alert is called and the lab is solved. This is it for today's lab. See you in the next one.